Hello, today I am going to explain you how to create a basic calculator from this Scratch programming language. So my basic calculator that I am going to create for you, that calculator is able to perform four arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, division and multiplication. Okay. So at the left hand side, you are able to see that there are so many block categories are given over here, and in a particular block category, there are so many sub-blocks are given over here. And in the middle, you will find the script area, and in the right-hand side, you will find the output area where your output is going to be executed when you write any particular script for your program. And as per that script, your sprite is going to be performed in the output area. Okay. So I am going to start my demonstration that how to create a basic calculator in Scratch. Okay. So first of all, I have to choose when green flag clicked from the event block category, then from the control I am going to select this forever block, and this green flag click block will execute your program. The green flag clicked block will execute it when the green flag is hit by the user, okay? And after that, the forever block is going to be executed for infinite time till you are not hitting to this stop button, okay? Because the name is given forever, it means it is going to be executed forever if you are not hitting the stop button. Now, in this forever, first of all, I have to create three variables. Now, variables will help you to store some kind of values like character values or numeric values or decimal values, okay? To perform some dynamic operations in your program. So, for that, this variable block is given. Now from the variable, I am creating one variable and I am putting the name of the variable is operator, where any operator is going to be stored like plus operator, minus operator, multiply operator or divide operator. Okay. After the operator variable, I am creating one more variable. The name of that one more variable is first number. Okay. So first number. Now I am going to create one more variable. The name of that variable is second number. Okay. The number variables will store some kind of values from the user, and it is going to be performed the arithmetic operations on these number variables. Okay. It means the values which are available inside the number variables. Now my next statement or my next block is from the sensing category block. In this sensing, you will find the ask block, which is help you to ask some kind of questions to the user. So my first question is, choose any one operator from the given list. Okay, so here I am putting the arithmetic operator symbols, okay, like plus, minus, multiply and divide, and user have to select only one operator. Okay, so the selection of user is now going to be stored in the answer block, which is part of the ask block, okay? Because whatever the answer is given by user, that is going to be automatically stored in this answer block. Now from this answer block, that particular selection of variable is going to be stored in the operator variable, okay? So from the variable block, you have to select set block, okay? By the set block, you are going to set the value of this operator variable, okay? So now in the set block, you have to select operator variable name, and then you have to put the answer block here, okay? Now just right click on the ask block and duplicate it and put in the down or below to this set block, and you have to change your question. The next question is, enter first number, okay? Now change the variable name from operator to first number, then again duplicate it, change the statement, enter second number, okay? Now change the variable name to second number. Now three questions you have asked to any user. Now user have given the answer of all your questions. Now the time is to perform the operations as per the selection of the user. So suppose user have selected minus, user have selected plus, or user have selected multiplication, or user have selected division operator. So to check as per to perform as per the user selection, you have to select a conditional block, that is if block, like if user have selected plus operator, the addition operation is going to be performed on the variables. Okay, so in this if block there is a space given where you have to put the relational operator. Okay, relational operator means the equal operator, the equal relation, where you are going to check that whatever value is available in the operator value, that is equal to the particular operator. Okay, so suppose my operator value is equal to plus operator, then the operation is going to be performed. Similarly, if the operator value is minus, so when the operator value is minus, this minus if block is going to be performed. Okay, duplicate it, then if user has selected multiplication, so multiplication operation is going to be performed. Suppose user have selected division, so division operation is going to be performed over here. Okay, so like this I have created these three if conditions. Now in the if conditions, for every particular operator, the sprite is going to be display the answer of the operation. Okay, whatever operations is now performing on the variable, that is going to be displayed by the sprite. It means the answer is going to be displayed by sprite or by this script. So to display the answer on the screen, you have to go to looks category and you have to select the say block. In the say block, the say block will help you to say a message through a sprite. So by the say block, I am going to display the answer of the each and every operation. So in the say block, I am going to put one operator, that is the join operator, which joins two different sentences or two different messages. Okay, so in the join block I am writing addition of two number is. Okay, here I am going to perform the addition by this addition operator. Okay, and in the addition operator I am going to put my variables first number and second number. Okay, like this, copy whole sentence, then come to the duplicate say block, put it in the if block of the subtraction, duplicate it again, put in the if block of multiplication, duplicate it again and put in the block of division. Okay, then change the sentence. Okay, instead of addition you have to write subtraction of two number is. So subtraction of two number is. Okay, subtraction of two number is, then you have to write multiplication. Of two number is, and you have to write division of two number is. Okay, now you have to change the operator also. So take this out and take this out, change the operators in each and every sentence. Okay, and again you have to put the variables name in the operator blocks. So go to variables and put the variables over here. Make sure you are putting the things on a correct place. Okay, if you are not writing the things on a correct place, your program is not going to be execute properly. Okay, so you have to put each and everything on the correct place. Okay, like this. Now the time is to check the program by running the program. So hit on the green flag. As you can see, my sprite is saying me a message, choose any one operator from the given list. Suppose I am selecting multiplication. Okay, and hit this right button, then enter first number. My first number is 10. Okay, my second number is 20. Okay, multiplication of two number is 200. Okay, then again if you want to see the output, suppose I am selecting plus operator, enter, then first number 20, enter, enter second number 30, press enter. Addition of two number is 50. So as you are able to see, my sprite is displaying me a correct output as per my given instructions. Okay, so it means my program is working properly. Thank you to watching this video. I hope so you are able to understand that how to create a program to make a basic calculator by using a scratch programming language.